the right to publish knowledge. And now I want to ask you, where does knowledge come from? The knowledge that we have today that's available to us in our textbooks, in the media, on the internet, who's writing it? Who's saying that these are facts? Hopefully it's not President Donald Trump. But and now I want to ask you, what point of view does it take? What point of view does a history book take? What point of view does your newspaper take? So the question, who has the right to generate and publish knowledge, is important, because most of the knowledge that we have access to in the world today is written by white men for white men. There's a huge knowledge gap in terms of people of color producing knowledge. There's a huge knowledge gap in terms of women producing knowledge. And this is why Wikipedia is so important, because who has the right to publish knowledge? You have the right to publish knowledge. And another important term in education is access, right? Like, we have these two sides of education for all: access and quality. So Wikipedia helps solve the access problem. It gives people access to information in their mother language. And these are some quotes from our 2015 annual report, and you can just see the impact that this has on people's lives. Ali from the United States said, "Wikipedia is why, even though I spent most of my adult life out of school as a refugee, when I finally got to a safe place and into a university, I was able not only to compete with my peers, but to excel." And Jyoti from India said, "It's the most important source of knowledge whenever I am in need." Thank you so much, Wikipedia. So people around the world, they access Wikipedia. They know what it is. Not many people know that they can contribute to Wikipedia, that they have the right to do so. So let's talk about how does the Wikipedia education program benefit students. Here's a quote from a student in Tokyo. "It made us look at the concept of homework in a different light." Would you agree with this term? Students learn best when they are engaged. Editing Wikipedia engages students. Here's why. Here we go. So all of these are present in a Wikipedia education program. There's global collaboration. As you saw, how many people from all over the world work on one single Wikipedia page. There's a higher purpose. They're contributing to open knowledge all over the world. They're going to become part of a community that's extremely collaborative and interesting. And there's really a sense of shared purpose among the community. There's choice built into the program, depending on how you use it in your classroom. There's differentiation. Students can work on different projects that they're interested in. And they're going to develop expertise at the same time. And so how does the Wikipedia education program benefit educators? An educator from Ecuador said, "I have never seen my students as motivated as when they were explaining the work they had done to upload pictures and videos to Wikipedia." Would you agree? I personally, and I might be biased because I was a classroom teacher for a long time and then I trained teachers for a while, but I really believe that teachers are some of the most hardworking, creative, and overworked and overtaxed and underappreciated individuals in our society. So it's really important to me that we provide teachers with opportunities that are going to help them to meet the overwhelming standards they have to achieve in the classroom on any given day, and make their life easier. We don't want to add any extra burden or make your life harder. We want to make your life easier, actually. So that's what we've set out to do. And so in today's classrooms, I mean, teachers, you have the job of preparing the next generation to be 21st century workers, right? And so they need to have 21st century skills. They need to know information literacy. They need to know what is a fact and not an alternative fact. They need to be able to use computers, use mobile technology. They need to be able to research and write, and they need to be able to become a global citizen as more and more of the workforce today is globalized. And all of these, Wikipedia and education can do all of these things. So let's give an example, information literacy. So this is a standard that's taken from the Partnership for 21st Century Learning. It says students identify sources of data, access data, critically evaluate it, and then use it to explore significant questions about our world. So if you take a look, if I click this link here, you can see that Wikipedia has rules for identifying reliable sources. And there's real-world consequences if a student add something to Wikipedia without a reliable source. For example, their edit could be reverted. They could be asked by a community member to add a more reliable source. So there's actually consequences. It's not just a bad grade. They're going to see that actually something happens because they didn't add a reliable source. And you can read here the actual rule. So Wikipedia articles should be based on reliable published sources, making sure that all majority and significant minority views that have appeared in those sources are covered. If no reliable source can be found on a topic, Wikipedia should not have an article on it. So Wikipedia is not just like any information you want to add. Like, I'm going to add a Wikipedia article about my grandma. You can't do that. If there's no reliable source covering your grandmother, I'm sorry, she can't be on Wikipedia. However, if your grandmother is like Jane Goodall, then yes, she can have a Wikipedia page. So here you can see that there are these skills that students need to achieve and learn are part of editing Wikipedia. It's already there. They're going to learn it. They're going to understand it. And at the same time, they're going to contribute to access to knowledge. So the bottom line is, your students will learn. You will have a community helping you achieve your learning targets using a digital resource that most students are already familiar with. So what's not to love? And just to bring it all back together, I hope that we have demonstrated that Wikimedia projects and education benefit students, educators, and society. And to give you a more specific example, I've asked Leon to share a case study of what he's been doing.